Hello everybody, we are back, and it's time for Marbus. Now Marbus is an interesting one. Once you know the kind of main way to exploit him, he's super easy. But unless you don't know that, then he can be quite tricky. So the thing in story mode is he can spawn minions whenever he wants, and he does have a set amount of minions he can spawn, and I believe it's 100, I think it's 111. It's definitely 111 in mission mode, but generally speaking, when he has minions out, your first priority is to kill those minions. They make dodging his attacks way, way harder. They are vulnerable when he first spawns them, so I was a bit greedy there. They are vulnerable when they first spawn, so you can always... you can always do forward Y if they're next to you and it will hit them. So I want to cover this straight away, and I was kind of glad he dive bombed. There is a really cheap exploit you can do here. When he does that, just do a just do Inazuma. I did mine too late. And it will stun lock him with XXY, 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 this string right here. You can just keep doing it over and over again. I wouldn't recommend really doing that though, as if you're gonna, if you're only gonna do that, you're never really gonna learn how to fight this boss. And he is an important boss to know how to fight properly. So he's got two. He's in a way actually thinking about it. He's kind of similar to Alma in his AI. He's got his kind of close quarters mode, and then he's got his projectile mode. He'll also do a really good job of killing his minions, which is good. So we don't have to deal with them. Use UTs whenever you get them. He makes it very, very easy to dodge his help. He is far... I just thought, the main difference with him on the higher difficulties, and you'll kind of notice it, he's far more prone to spawning minions on the high difficulties. So you can just armor through that grab. That grab is unblockable, but it won't go through your armor. So you can do, like, Gleaming Blade or Haste Straight Slash. You know, anything with full armor, you'll be able to get through that grab, no problem. So again, we've got more minions. Using Windrun, by the way, is a really good way to get out the way of that fireball attack. If he does that when there's minions about, it can be pretty tricky to dodge it. So abusing Windrun is actually a really good way to get around that. You also have Izuna Drop as well with the Dragon Sword. Heavy weapon UTs are really good against Marbus, in particular the Debilero. I'll show that real quick. It's one of the safest ways to fight him. It's just roll under him, charge up a level 3 UT. And as you can see, I thought that would hit him. The hitbox, like the vertical hitbox on the Debilero UT is really, really high. So even if he's kind of flying in the air, like right here, a Debilero UT would hit him easily. So Nimpo doesn't really matter, but if you want to just really play it safe and get rid of the minions, just use Inazuma. Now, you can deal damage to him if you want to be aggressive with the Dragon Sword pretty easily. Forward Y, XY will always hit him if you're underneath him and he's not too far up. So that's kind of your main way to be aggressive rather than wait for him to, you know, do his dive bomb and attack. You can also do this. Be very careful doing too many hits of this though. So right here, I'm just going to take this into an Izuna drop and easily dodge all these projectiles. Ideally, that should have been a yellow essence, but it doesn't matter. That's a pretty funny the way he tries to follow you right there. So we'll take him out. Okay, so we'll get into now the main way to deal damage to him when he does his dive bomb. It's great when he just spawns them right next to you like that. As you can see, they're always vulnerable whenever they spawn, so their defense isn't activated straight away. Okay, so this is actually really good. Nope, he doesn't do the dive bomb. So, if you stand underneath Marbus, he'll sometimes do his slam attack, where he just slams down to the ground. Like that one right there. That is unblockable, so make sure you get out of the way of it. It doesn't do a whole lot of damage, especially with your health bar this size. But you don't want to get hit by it, even so. So as you can see there, like, the Gleaming Blade is able to hit him. He's not doing his dive bomb, is he? Okay, we need a dive bomb here. There we go. So when he does this dive bomb, just roll underneath it, and your attack here, you can be anything you want, really. You can use the Gleaming Blade, you can use the Debilero's, like, you know, full Debilero combo string. If you want to play it safe, you should have the Dark Dragon Blade by now, by the way, on anything above normal, as you should have 50 Scarabs. A really safe way to deal a lot of damage is do forward Y, do your Fire Wheels, cancel your Nimpo, equip it again, do forward Y again, do it again, and then roll through this grab, and then do forward Y again. The Dark Dragon Blade doesn't do a whole lot of damage, but it's pretty decent, and it's a pretty easy way to do it. One forward Y will also kill the Crab Fiends in one hit, so that's a nice That's a nice thing to have. The good way to think about the Dark Dragonblade is against weapon against enemies that don't have the immunity on the low health UF. It's similar in function to the low health UF. You just don't have to be at low health to really use it, you know, to its full effectiveness. As you can see, like, that is a pretty nice chunk off of, you know, a boss this late in the game on the highest difficulty. So that pretty much covers Marbus, guys. He's actually pretty straightforward. You just really know, you just have to play it safe against him, really. A lot of these bosses, really, especially the late ones, you really just have to play it safe, and you really won't go far wrong. That's why you always want to take it into an Izuna drop. Sometimes you won't actually always do a ground pound, but it's always just best to play it safe. So that attack, as you can see, is very easily evaded with just roll jumps. That, there's such a big wind-up on it. Just get comfortable with the timing. This attack right here will guard break you. It won't guard crush you. His fireballs will guard crush you, by the way, so I'm trying not to kill him here as I want to showcase some more of his attacks. Okay, so here, like, they guard crush you. This is unblockable, by the way, and as you can see, it does hurt. It does do quite a bit of damage. His ground pound is unblockable. That is something you don't see every day. He's pretty much. I could have light up Nimpo there, but again, I didn't want to kill him. I'm trying to think if there's any more attack. Oh yeah, projectiles completely ineffective. And I think that's pretty much it. I don't think there's any attacks of his I haven't covered. Yep, that's it, guys. I can't think of anything else. So that is it for Marbus. I hope this helped. We'll kick him in the face to finish him off. And I hope there's only a few left now. There's a lot more bosses in this game. I remember when I got to chapter 13, I thought, yeah, there's not many left. And then I counted, and there's still, like, you know, 8 bosses left. So the Emperors are next, and I'll see you guys in that video. Take care.